Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. I want to talk to somebody about that's very, very concerning for every single dog owner and dog trainer out there. And if you're not aware of it, Hillsborough County, Florida is going to try to pass an ordinance. And I want people to first, I want people to fully understand that this has actually nothing to do with remote collars or prong collars or choke chains. Because what happens is a lot of people jump on that. They're like, yeah, we don't want prong collars or remote collars used. Fine. I get it. This is bigger than this. Every single dog owner and every single dog trainer, though, should be horrified by this ordinance that they are trying to pass. This is a PETA-driven ordinance. If you're not familiar, PETA actually doesn't want you to own a dog in your house. I'm not quite sure if you're familiar with PETA and their agenda. But let me just read something, and I want people to remember that this has got nothing to do with prong collars. In no way shall a dog trainer use or promote any aversive training method or technique. Now, does that mean that a dog owner is allowed to? So a dog trainer is not? So if this passes, are dog trainers not allowed to, but dog owners allowed to? I mean, if you're trying to pass an ordinance, it's actually really important to know this stuff. No way shall a dog trainer use or promote any aversive training method or technique. Use techniques that are improper for the particular breed or behavior of the dog. What does that mean? You know what I mean? What is that? Like, a large dog gets a certain type of training and a small dog gets another type of training? So let me ask a good question. Is it okay for small dogs to bite but not large dogs to bite? I'm being 100% serious. This is a major concern for all dog owners in the United States, but in Hillsborough County, Florida, Tampa area, they're trying to pass this. Now listen to this. So you cannot use a technique that is improper for the particular behavior or breed, causes undue physical or mental discomfort, is cruel, painful, or will cause or likely to cause injury, torment, suffering, or death. These are all emotionally fueled comments. Now, first of all, let me give everybody a good example. If you don't train your dog to recall and it gets hit by a car, because your lack of a good recall training created death. Mental discomfort. You can't do anything, any training at all to do mental discomfort. Now, I want people to think about this rationally, because if this ordinance passes, it has nothing to do with remote collars or prong collars. If you're walking your dog on a body harness, say you're walking your dog on a body harness, and it sees another dog, and you cannot get it under control, and it is barking its head off and pulling you. We easily, any rational person could say that the dog is underneath mental and physical discomfort. I think we all can agree on that. You will not be allowed to walk your dog. You will not be allowed to train your dog. The fact that they're trying to pass a law, it sounds good. Oh, of course we don't want to create discomfort in our dogs. Oh, there are fur babies. We only want to love them. Well, last time I got bit, I was giving a treat to a dog. So again, this is not a remote collar or prong collar. This is actually worse than a remote collar and prong collar ban. You will not be allowed to train your dog with any aversive. Now, I want people to understand what an aversive is. The word no is an aversive. You will not be allowed to say the word no if you are a dog trainer. You read the law. Interpret it the way it is written. Take away all the preconceptions you have of what training is. Imagine a 30, Imagine a 20 to 80 pound dog pulling on its leash. You're never allowed to say no. You'll break the ordinance. You can never create anything that might cause it mentally uncomfortable. Okay, you ready for this? My five-year-old showed up to kindergarten without any pants on. No pants. No pants on at all. All right? The teacher calls me up. Jeff, your son has no pants on. Why? Well, I wanted to put pants on my son, but my son started having a temper tantrum, and I didn't want to create any mental anguish, so I sent my son to school with no pants. I am serious. This is how terrible it has been. You know what? My son just took a test and got a C+. That created a lot of mental anguish with my child. My children can only get straight A's no matter how good they do in school. I want all you teachers to be on alert that you've got to give my children straight A's. Anything less than an A, anything less than an A creates mental anguish. Now, I want you to know I've got a really, really sensitive high school student. And her best friend didn't get perfect grades. She committed suicide. Her low grades were connected to her death. My children will get straight A's because I don't want anything less than a straight A to contribute to their death. I know I'm sort of reaching, but this concept of you can't do anything with your dog that would create mental anguish, mental stress. This is how ridiculous it is getting. Now, somebody's going to come back, and I'm going to delete all the nonsense down in the bottom. Someone's going to come back saying, F you, you're an ass. Like, I get called an asshole all the time. Just to let you know, calling me an asshole is not a very good discussion point. Great. I'm an asshole, but I'm very aware of how to train a dog. Think about this rationally. When you go to any pure positive reinforcement class, any of them, maybe some people have never been in them before, walk in, you will see stressed out dogs. Dogs struggling with mental and physical anguish. You will see dogs in discomfort from pulling on flat buckle collars, martingales, head halters. You will see dogs being corrected. All illegal. All illegal. Dog owners need to stand up and start fighting for their rights. And the people that are coming up with these nonsense magic dust laws, which is driven by PETA, by the way, because they don't want dogs in your home. This is not a prong collar and remote collar conversation. This is a dog ownership conversation. People should be furious. Furious that this is happening. Just Google it. Just Google it. Google it. How can we fighting for that? The best thing you can do to fight for it is get involved, to show up for the meetings, to make tons of videos of you working with dogs, to educate the general public. You can get, if you're a dog owner that's been changed by dog training, you know, make a testimonial video, put stuff up. Remember, this is not a prong collar thing. You can't say no to your dog. You can't say no to your dog if this passes. That's an aversive. It's in the law. People go, oh, no, that's not what they meant. No. That's what they are saying, though. That is what they are saying. So whoever's coming up with this stuff, I don't know where they're getting their information from, but it's very scary. Dog owners need to step up, and they should be highly, highly upset. So some of the public comments from the meeting last night where, well, we want dogs to be able to just do what dogs naturally do. What? Like, pull? Run away? Growl? Jump? Bite? Dogs naturally do all that stuff. All that stuff. So you want a dog to run away from you and get hit by a car. You want a dog to jump on everybody that they meet. You want a dog to drag you down the streets. This is real. It is happening in 2017. Just because I'm a balance trainer, this has got nothing to do with balance training whatsoever. You know? It's read the information. They're not saying you can't use a prong collar or a remote collar. They're saying you can't use an aversive. You can't create any mental anguish. You can't stress your dog out. So that's it. I think everybody should be furious. I think every dog owner should be furious. And this is not me. Well, and this is the comments I'm going to get. And this is how far reaching everybody is. Oh, well, he's the guy that uses the prong collars and the remote collars. I'm like, who cares what I do? It's got nothing to do with me. You know, I'm fine. But dog owners, you're in trouble. You are in a lot of trouble. You're in a lot of trouble. So, and this is the thing about people that say they're positive reinforcements. If this law passes, I assure you, I'll be able to walk in there and I'll be able to say mental anguish. Mental anguish, mental anguish, stress, aversive. You're breaking the law. Hillsborough, Tampa area, Hillsborough County, Florida. So it was last night, there was a meeting, and it's horrific. It is horrific. People should be furious, furious. No aversive, no mental anguish. So... Paradise Found Florida. I'll put some stuff up. I'll put up some information, all right? And the IACP, if you're a member of the IACP, Tyler Muto, the president, is putting information together. But it's happening right before your eyes, everybody. Right before your eyes, your rights as a dog owner are being taken away. They are being taken away. And someone, you know, this is the thing. And if someone says, oh, well, we should only use positive reinforcement, you can't do that anymore, though. That argument won't work anymore. Does that make sense? A positive reinforcement trainer is not allowed to train dogs either. You can't train any dog anymore. Everything's an aversive. All dogs struggle with stress when they're being trained. It's not about, but Linda, it's not about that no one follows the ordinance. It's that it's on the books. It's on the books, and somebody could enforce it. You know, somebody could enforce it. That's the problem. That's the problem. All right? All right. Take care, everybody. Madly in love with you. Don't sit back. Do not sit back. Fight, 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 fight. All right? Everybody should be pissed. Everybody should be furious. It's got nothing to do. I want to clarify. This has nothing to do with prong collars and remote collars or choke chains. It has nothing to do with that. Those are not even mentioned. Okay? Take care. Bye-bye.